What would you do if you knew you only had 1 month to live? For most of us, if we knew we only had 1 month to live, we'd live our lives differently. We'd be more authentic about who we are and more deliberate about how we spend the time we have. So the real question is, what keeps us from living this way now? I'm Carrie Shook.
And I'm Chris Shook. And in our new book, 1 Month to Live, 30 Days to a No Regrets Life, we challenge you to start living your life as though you only had 1 month to live. At the end of this 30-day experience, we believe that your life will be completely changed because you'll be living the life you're always made for.
Our motivation to write the book, and better yet, to live out this 1 month to live lifestyle, was born in part from our ministry experience. As pastor of Fellowship of the Woodlands, one of America's fastest growing and largest churches, we've had the privilege to walk alongside a lot of people through the years who face the end of their life. And most of those people made radical changes when they realized their time on earth was limited.
They take license to say what they really feel and do what they really want. They ask for forgiveness and forgive others. They take risks they never would have taken before. And they gain a new sense of clarity about their priorities, like their relationship with God and the kind of legacy that they want to leave that will endure.
So we begin to ask ourselves, why can't all of us live like that? Isn't that the way we were meant to live in the first place? So last year at a staff retreat, I did a little experiment. I asked our team, what would you do if you knew you only had 1 month to live? How would you live your life differently? I gave them all a journal and I asked them to live the next 30 days as if they were their last, and then to write down what happened.
The results were nothing less than life-changing. Now, some people did big once-in-a-lifetime things, like take their spouse on a trip to Hawaii, or restore a relationship with a parent that had been sour for years. But for many of us, it was just the daily little things that gained a new sense of purpose and beauty and clarity. At the end of the 30 days, every single one of us had a renewed sense of passion for our lives.
Recently, we were taking a walk to the beach and we took a shortcut to an old cemetery. And as I looked at the old gravestones, I couldn't help but recognize that a person's whole life could be reduced to 2 dates and a dash in between. Now, some of the markers had Bible verses or sayings on them, but really it comes down to what transpired between the 2 dates. It comes down to the dash.
It's startling to realize that a person's whole life is summed up in that one little dash, connecting 2 numbers. And as we would look at the individual markers, we would look at that little dash, that short little line, and we would wonder, what was their life like? Who did they love? What were their passions? What were their mistakes and regrets?
When you think about it, there's not a lot we have control over in life. You don't get to decide where you'll be born. You don't get to decide when you'll be born. You don't get to decide who your parents will be. You don't get to decide the dates on your tombstone. But there is one thing we have a vast amount of control over. We get to decide how we spend the dash. We get to decide how we spend that dash of time between the 2 dates of our earthly existence. So how are you spending your dash? Are you dashing around hurriedly trying to chase things that don't really matter? Or are you being who God created you to be, living passionately, being fully alive, living the life you were made for? The psalmist prayed, Lord, teach us to number our days and to recognize how few they are so that we can spend them wisely. God wants you to spend the dash of time that He's given you wisely, making the most of it.
In this book, we're challenging you to start living your life as though you only had 1 month to live. And there are 4 universal principles in this 1 month to live lifestyle: to live passionately, to love completely, to learn humbly, and to leave boldly. And the book is divided into 4 sections or weeks. And in each day or chapter, there's a primary focus to help you live out that week's principle in your own life.
We believe after reading the book, you'll be living the life you were made for. Someone said that our lives are not really counted by the number of breaths we take, but by the number of moments that take our breath away. And it's our hope and prayer that you'll experience many of those moments.